إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. بعد، today is Sunday 7th جمادى الأولى 1446 correspondence in November 10th 2024. Today we'll explain page 460 of Surah Az-Zumar, chapter 39. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. قل يا عبادي الذين آمنوا اتقوا ربكم للذين أحسنوا في هذه الدنيا حسنة وأرض الله واسعة إنما يوفى الصابرون أجرهم بغير حساب قل إني أمرت أن أعبد الله مخلصا له الدين وأمرت لأن أكون أول المسلمين. The command for taqwa, emigration, and to worship Allah alone with all sincerity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands his believing servants to remain steadfast in their obedience and have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not to feel hopeless, and not to feel like the people of the book who thought that it's taken so long before the day of judgment, so their hearts became hard, as Allah says in Surah Al-Hadid. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to them, O my servants who believe, have taqwa of your Lord. Good reward is for those who do good deeds in this world. Meaning the one who does good deeds in this world will have good reward in this world and in the hereafter. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَرِنَا أُنْثَى فَلَنُحْيِيَنَّهُ وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ condition. وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ فَلَنُحْيِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً وَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْرَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Whomever does a good deed, whether male or female, with the condition that he is a believer, and believer means that you have faith in the heart and you have the deeds with the limbs, does not only mean, just like the Christians claim, you just need to believe, or like the Murji'a claim, you just need to believe in your heart. No, you have to do deeds as well. So if you do that, then Allah shall give you a pleasant life in this world, and in the hereafter you will go to Jannah. وَأَرْضُ اللَّهِ وَاسِعَةٌ. And Allah's earth is spacious, Mujahid said. So emigrate through it, and strive hard, and keep away from idols. إنما يوفى الصابرون أجرهم بغير حساب. Only those who are patient shall receive their reward in full without reckoning. الأوزاعي said their reward will not be weighed or measured. They will be given an immense reward. السدي said إنما يوفى الصابرون أجرهم بغير حساب means in paradise. So they will be sent to paradise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says next, قُلْ إِنِّي أُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصًا لَهُ الدِّينَ. Say, verily, I am commanded to worship Allah, making the religion sincerely for Him. Means I am commanded to worship Allah alone in all sincerity with no partner or associate. And I am commanded this in order that I may be the first of Muslims. وَأُمِرْتُ لِأَنْ أَكُونَ أَوَّلَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Next, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ إِنِّي أَخَافُ إِنْ عَصَيْتُ رَبِّي عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. قُلِ اللَّهَ أَعْبُدُ مُخْلِصًا لَهُ دِينِي فَاعْبُدُوا مَا شِئْتُم مِّن دُونِهِ قُلْ إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَهْلِيهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَلَا ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينُ. لَهُم مِّن فَوْقِهِمْ ظُلَلٌ مِّنَ النَّارِ وَمِن تَحْتِهِمْ ظُلَلٌ ذَلِكَ يُخَوِّفُ اللَّهُ بِهِ عِبَادَهُ يَا عِبَادِ فَاتَّقُونِ. Creating fear of the punishment of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even though you are the messenger of Allah, that you fear the punishment of Allah if you were to disobey your Lord. إِنِّي أَخَافُ إِنْ عَصَيْتُ رَبِّي عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. The great day is the day of resurrection. This is a conditional sentence, actually subjunctive. And if what is referred to here applies to the Prophet ﷺ, that means it applies even more to others. So Prophet ﷺ said, if I were to disobey, this doesn't mean that he is disobeying ﷺ, but he's telling people that, look, even me, if I were to disobey Allah, Allah would punish me. So how about you who are lower in level than Muhammad ﷺ, by extension, you would get punished as well. قل الله أعبد مخلصا له ديني فأعبدوا من فأعبدوا ما شئتم من دونه. Say Allah alone I worship by doing religious deeds sincerely for His sake only. So worship what you like besides Him. This is also a threat and a disowning of them. قل إن الخاسرين الذين خسروا أنفسهم وأهليهم يوم القيامة. Say the losers, mean the great losers of all, are those who lose themselves and their families on the day of resurrection. That means they will be separated from their families and will never meet again, either because their families have gone to paradise and they have gone to hellfire, or they are all in hellfire but they are separated from one another. They will never meet or feel happiness again. ألا ذلك هو الخسران المبين. Verily, that will be a manifest loss, meaning this is the clearest and most obvious loss, that in the hereafter you're in hellfire and you're not with your loved ones. Then he subhanahu wa ta'ala describes their state in the hellfire where he says, لهم من فوقهم ظلل من النار ومن تحتهم ظلل. They shall have coverings of fire above them and covering of fire beneath them. This is the meaning of the ayah Islauha. Islau, that means you enter hellfire and it's going to be surrounding you. You're going to have coverings of fire above you and beneath you. This is like the ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-A'raf, لَهُمْ مِنْ جَهَنَّمَ مِهَادٌ وَمِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ غَوَاشٌ وَكَذَلِكَ نَجَزِّي الظَّالِمِينَ. Theirs will be a bed of hellfire and over them coverings of hellfire. Thus do we recompense the wrongdoers. يَوْمَ يَغْشَاهُمُ الْعَذَابُ مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ وَمِنْ تَحْتِ أَرْجُلِهِمْ وَيَقُولُ ذُوقُوا مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. On the day when the torment, the hellfire, shall cover them from above them and from underneath their feet, and will be said to them, taste what you used to do. ذَلِكَ يُخَوِّفُ اللَّهُ بِهِ عِبَادَهُ. With this, Allah frightens His servants, meaning Allah tells us about this, which will undoubtedly come to pass, to frighten His servants, so that they will keep away from unlawful things and from sin. Ya ibadi fattaqun, O my servants, therefore have taqwa of me, mean fear my punishment, fear my wrath, fear my anger, and fear my vengeance. Not take committing sins lightly. وَالَّذِينَ اجْتَنَبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ أَن يَعْبُدُوهَا وَأَنَابُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ لَهُمُ الْبُشْرَى فَبَشِّرْ عِبَادِ. الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه أولئك الذين هداهم الله وأولئك هم أولو الألباب. عبد الرحمن بن زيد بن أسلم said, narrating from his father, والذين جتنبوا الطاغوت يعبدوها. Those who avoided الطاغوت by not worshiping them was revealed concerning Zayd bin Amr bin Nufail and Abu Dharr and Salman al-Farisi. May Allah be pleased with them. The correct views that includes them and all others who are in their state, who avoided worshiping idols and turned to the worship of Ar-Rahman solely and sincerely for Him. These are the people for whom there is good news in this world and the hereafter. Ask Allah to make us and our progeny among them. And turn to Allah for them a glad tidings. Then Allah says, فَبَشِّرْ عِبَادِ أَلَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَ. So announce the good news to my servants, those who listen to the word and follow the best things that they hear about these words, meaning those who understand the word and act in accordance with it. This is like the words of Allah, may Allah be exalted, to Musa alayhi salam, when he gave him the Torah. He said, فَخُذْهَا بِقُوَّةٍ وَأْمُرْ قَوْمَكَ يَأْخُذُوا بِأَحْسَنِهَا. Hold onto these with firmness and enjoin your people to take the better therein. So the word are the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When people who understand these commands and act in accordance with them, Allah gives them glad tidings of paradise, and Allah says that those are whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided, means those who are described in this manner are the ones whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided in this world and the hereafter. أولئك الذين هداهم الله وأولئك هم أولو الألباب. And those are men of understanding, meaning they possess sound reasoning and an upright nature. Because how can someone claim that he has an upright nature when he worships someone other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the whole universe and runs its affairs by himself subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَفَمَنْ حَقَّ عَلَيْهِ كَلِمَةُ الْعَذَابِ أَفَأَنْتَ تُنْقِذُ مَنْ فِي النَّارِ لكن الذين اتقوا ربهم لهم غرف من فوقها غرف مبنية تجري من تحتها الأنهار وعد الله لا يخلف الله الميعاد. الله says أفمن حق عليه كلمة العذاب أفأنت تنقذ من في النار. Is then one against whom the word of punishment is justified because he was ordered to obey Allah but then he disobeyed Allah, will you rescue him who is in the fire? Allah says, if he subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed that someone is to be doomed, can you save him from his misguidance and doom? Which means no one can guide him apart from Allah, because whomever Allah leaves astray cannot be guided, and whomever he guides cannot be led astray. لكن الذين اتقوا ربهم لهم غرف فوقها غرف مبنية. But those who have taqwa of their Lord, have taqwa mean to obey the commands and stay away from those things that Allah forbade us from. Allah tells that His blessed servants will have lofty rooms in paradise. من فوقها غرف مبنية. And above these lofty rooms are other lofty rooms that are built one above another. Just like you know what we see about buildings or homes or castles. So story upon story, solidly constructed, adorned and high. Abdullah bin Imam Ahmad recorded that Ali radiallahu anhu said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna fil jannati la ghurafan yura butunaha min dhuhuriha wa dhuhuruha min butunaha." In paradise there are rooms whose inside can be seen from the outside and the outside can be seen from the inside. Of course, only the owners of these rooms will be able to see it. Doesn't mean that everyone will be able to see it, because of course in these rooms are the women that belong to the inhabitant of this castle in paradise, or these castles, these edifices. A Bedouin asked the Prophet ﷺ, "Who are these rooms for?" The Prophet ﷺ said, "لمن أطاب الكلام وأطعم الطعام وصلى بالليل والناس النيام." These rooms are for those who speak kindly, feed the hungry, and stand in prayer at night whilst the people are sleeping. This is also recorded by Tirmidhi, who said that this hadith is authentic in the level of Hassan, while there is one single narrator in the chain of narration, that's the meaning of Gharib. Imam Ahmad recorded from Sahal bin Sa'd, may Allah please with him, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna ahla al-jannati la yatara'awna fil ghurfati fil jannah kama tara'awna al-kawkaba fi ufuqi as-sama'." The people of paradise will look towards each other in raised places of paradise as you look towards the stars on the horizons of the sky. He said, I told Al-Nu'man bin Abi Ayyash about that, and he said, I heard Abu Sa'id Al-Khudri, may Allah be pleased with him, narrate it. كَمَا تَرَى أَوْنَ الْكَوْكَبَ الَّذِي فِي الْأُفُقِ الشَّرْقِيِّ أَوِ الْغَرْبِيِّ. As you see the stars on the horizon of the east or the west. It was also recorded in two Sahihs. Imam Ahmad said, Fazara narrated to us, Fulayh narrated to us from Hilal bin Ali, from Ata bin Yasar, from Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ أَهْلَ الْجَنَّةِ لَيَتَرَاءَوْنَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ أَهْلَ الْغُرَفِ كَمَا تَرَاءَوْنَ الْكَوْكَبَ الدُّرِّيَّ الْغَارِبَ فِي الْأُفُقِ الطَّالِعِ فِي تَفَاضُلِ أَهْلِ الدَّرَجَاتِ. The people of paradise will look towards each other in the raised places of paradise as you look at the high bright stars which remain on the horizon. Such will be the difference in superiority which some of them have over others. They said, on Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, are those the abodes of the prophets? He said, Bala walladhi nafsi biyadihi wa aqwamun amanu billahi wa saddaqu ar-rusul. Yes, it's not, no, actually, Bala means yes, by the one in whose hand is my soul, they are the abodes of people who believed in Allah and in the messengers. So yes, so it is the abodes of prophets and also those people who believed in Allah and His messengers. تجري من تحتها الأنهار وعد الله لا يخلف الله الميعاد. Under which rivers flow means the rivers flow wherever the people want them to flow. So the people of paradise, wherever they wish for the rivers to flow, they will flow. And this is the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Means all that we have mentioned here is what Allah has promised to His believing servants. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not fail in His promise. لا يخلف الله الميعاد. ألم تر أن الله أنزل من السماء ماء فسلكه ينابيع في الأرض ثم يخرج به زرعا مختلفا ألوانه ثم يهيج فتراه مصفرا ثم يجعله حطاما إن في ذلك لذكرى لأولي الألباب أفمن شرح الله صدره للإسلام فهو على نور من ربه فويل للقاسية قلوبهم من ذكر الله أولئك في ضلال مبين. The example of the love of this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ألم تر أن الله أنزل من السماء ماء. See, you know that Allah sends down water from the sky. Allah tells us that water originates in the sky. This is like there where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Furqan, وَأَنزَلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً طَهُورًا. And we send down pure water from the sky. So Allah sends down water from the sky and it settles in the earth. Then He causes it to flow wherever He subhanahu wa ta'ala wills, and He causes springs, great and small, to flow as needed. Allah says, فَسَلَكَهُ يَنَابِيعَ فِي الْأَرْضِ, and causes it to penetrate the earth as water springs. Sa'id bin Jubair and Amir al-Sha'bi said that all the water on earth has its origins in the sky. Sa'id bin Jubair said its origins lie in the snow, meaning the snow piles up in the mountains, then settles at the bottom of the mountains, and springs flow from the bottom of them. Yeah, but still, snow, how is it formed? It's coming from water that or snow that falls from the sky. So sky is the origin of water. ثُمَّ يُخْرِجُ بِهِ زَرْعًا مُخْتَلِفًا أَلْوَانُهُ, and afterwards thereby produces crops of different colors, meaning then from the water which comes down from the sky or flows from springs in the earth, He subhanahu wa ta'ala brings forth crops of different colors, different kinds of forms, tastes, scents, benefits, etc. ثُمَّ يَهِيجُ فَتَرَاهُ مُصْفَرًّا, and after that they wither and you see them turn yellow, meaning they have been ripened fresh. After they have been ripened fresh, they become old, and you see them turn yellow when they have dried out and they're about to die out. Then He makes them dry and broken pieces, means they become brittle. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَذِكْرَى لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ, verily, and this is a reminder for men of understanding, meaning those who are reminded by this and who learned the lesson from it, how the water comes down, plants grow, become green and strong, and then after that they wither away. In this itself is an ayah, because the world is like this. The world is green and fresh and beautiful, then it will become old and ugly. The young man will become a weak, senile old man, and after all of that comes death. The blessed one is the one whose state after death will be good. Allah often likens the life of this world to the way He sends down water from the sky, and crops and fruits grow thereby. Then they become dry and brittle after they spend their appointed time that Allah decreed for these crops to stay in this earth. This is like the ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَانْضْرِبْ لَهُمْ مَثَلَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا كَمَاءٍ أَنْزَلْنَاهُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فَاخْتَلَطَ بِهِ نَبَاتُ الْأَرْضِ فَأَصْبَحَ هَشِيمًا تَذْرُوهُ الرِّيَاحُ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ مُقْتَدِرًا. And put forward to them the example of the life of this world. It is like the water rain which we send down from the sky, and the vegetation of the earth mingles with it and becomes fresh and green. But later it becomes dry and broken pieces which the winds scatter, and Allah is able to do everything. So after strength comes weakness. The people of truth and the people of misguidance are not equal. أَفَمَنْ شَرَحَ اللَّهُ صَدْرَهُ لِلْإِسْلَامِ فَهُوَ عَلَى نُورٍ مِّنْ رَبِّهِ, is he whose... Okay, this is for next week, inshallah. This is the end of what we read today. The end of the page. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to teach us the beneficial knowledge Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from all trials and tribulations. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from the trials that are coming our way, as the Prophet told us about. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us and our families and our progenies. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring back the Muslims to the true path, especially the women, the youth among them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make the Muslims gather around the single leader, al-Mahdi al-Muntadhar, for him to establish Islam and justice in this world, the same way that it has been filled with injustice. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to destroy the state of the Jews. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to destroy their state and destroy with them the hypocrites and the disbelievers who are helping them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make them taste the severest punishment for killing the tens of thousands of our brothers and sisters. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to turn into pigs these scholars that that condone the killings of the Mujahideen, as the Prophet told us about that, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will turn into pigs the scholars that are speaking for the benefit of the rulers instead of speaking for the truth. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give our brothers the Mujahideen in Palestine, in Lebanon, in Yemen, in Syria, in Iraq, in Iran, and everywhere. Jihad is waged for the sake of Allah. I ask Allah to give them victory over the enemies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And finally, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us with gathering with Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam in the highest paradise of the Firdaus. Wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. And jazakumullahu khair, brothers, for your patience.